लोया में अड़बुल एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू ऑल ऑफ यू म्यूट योर माइक्स ओके इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एनर्जी कंजर्वेशन और law of conservation of energy with different applications with some beautiful figures and we extend our discussion into first law of thermodynamics and there we have seen okay I will participate I will share my screen. Many people are joining just now. What is first law of thermodynamics applied to a cycle? How is first law of thermodynamics stated for a cyclic process, for a cycle? For a cyclic process, the net work in the cycle is equal to net heat in the cycle. And for change of state, when a change of state has occurred, whether reversibly or irreversibly, then the first law of thermodynamics is discussed with a simple formula. I have asked this simple formula every time when I attempted a figure corresponding to that equation to make ourselves thorough with that equation, and of course I did not satisfy with your response earlier. Anyhow, I am asking you again: what is first law of thermodynamics applied to a change of state, and what is the corresponding equation? One of you unmute yourself and reply. For a change of state, how is the first law of thermodynamics applied? How is the first law of thermodynamics explained?
Sir, a machine cannot produce energy by using some energy. You cannot produce any energy, sir, from a machine.
Okay, don't confuse yourself. A machine can produce energy only with a corresponding input of energy. Or in converse or in reverse, we can say no machine can produce energy without corresponding input of energy or expenditure of energy. And you can say it is impossible to construct a perpetual motion machine of first kind. Under which category did we study all these this type of machines? That is, I told you under the corollaries of first law of thermodynamics. Corollaries, upasiddhantalu antaru telugulo, upasiddhantalu. First law of thermodynamics or law of conservation of energy is a statement, a theory. And the corollaries they are under this theory. All these are corollaries are derived from the fundamental theory, that is law of conservation of energy or first law of thermodynamics. Again, that's why the statement what you said, of course you confused a little bit, but however you understood this, and in your own terms you explained this. On this machine, what is this machine called? What you said, that machine is called as this one, this perpetual motion machine now, and this is sometimes abbreviated as PMM. P stands for perpetual, M motion, machine, PMM one, PMM one. We can say that a PMM one or perpetual motion machine of first kind. This, for example, I write here. This is PMM one. PMM one is impossible. Now this is see, in a very concise manner, one can. I'm coming. One can state the corollary or first of thermodynamics in other way, as PMM one is impossible. Making PMM one is impossible. What is PMM one? A machine which works without corresponding expenditure of energy. That is impossible. That is impossible. So what is PM? Now what is in what way PMM one is explained? In very simple terminology, I am telling you what is PMM one. This why I am asking you about this PMM one is because this concept has been given in the examinations because of its importance. Its importance, and with reference to this, many theories are explained or established. What is PMM one? You told me just now. Somebody told. Of course, a little bit confusion. A little bit confusion. You told. Now, with the refined answer, you now again repeat your answer. What is PMM one? See, when I asked about first law of thermodynamics for change of state, you attempted to explain PMM. Of course, you deviate. Still, it is important, and therefore, I am again coming from PMM. PMM one. What is PMM one? PMM one means, I repeat, P, perpetual. Perpetual means which continuously works. Motion, moves, motion. A machine which continuously moves, which continuously works without any input of energy. That is what PMM one means, and it is impossible. It is impossible. That is what again the first law of thermodynamics and its consequence. The consequence of first law of thermodynamics, or one of the corollaries of first law of thermodynamics, is PMM one. Perpetual motion machine of first kind. One stands for first kind. But then you may have some doubt. What is PMM two? Yes, it will come when second law of thermodynamics is attempted. After second law of thermodynamics is attempted, PMM two. Here a PMM one is not following first law of thermodynamics. We call the word not following. I write here a machine. I am writing a machine which violates here I am writing what is meant by violation which violates violates means not obeying or following. I am writing for your convenience because somebody felt a difficulty with English terminology. Of course, you will be habituated once you listen to this. Emission which violates the first law. The first law. I am writing just to see. First law of thermodynamics. Is called thermodynamics. Is called. Now you can define PMM1 like this. Is called a PMM1. A PMM1. So now the definition of PMM1, you can frame in your own words like this. A machine which violates means not obeying or not accepting, not following. The first law of thermodynamics is called PMM1. How is the perpetual motion machine of first kind? He is not obeying first law of thermodynamics. Okay, how is a PMM1 not obeying or not following the first law of thermodynamics? Because a PMM1 is defined like this: a machine which produces energy without a corresponding expenditure of input energy. That is PMM. It is impossible. Or in reverse, we can state like this: no machine will produce energy, output energy, without a corresponding input energy. Like this. If that is possible, that is called PMM1. But PMM1 is impossible. Perpetual motion machine of first kind. Perpetual motion machine means a machine which continuously works without any expenditure of work. Any expenditure of energy. For example, you just imagine our human body. We cannot work continuously without taking food. That is how you can understand perpetual motion machine of first kind. Unless you take some food after you are exhausted, after your energy is completely lost, you cannot work. You will no more work. Like that, a PMM1 also. That is what a PMM1 means. Then why is this defined? It is an idealization with which a theory can be better explained. A theory can be better explained, or a new theory can be established without any faults, better understanding. But with better understanding, a new theory or this first law can be understood. So that is why these idealized machines are, and you can write one more sentence, PMM1 is an ideal machine. Ideal machine, which is again impossible. an ideal machine, which is again impulse. Now, one of you tell me what is PMMR? I repeat, why this is being attempted? Because somebody has deviated, then change of state, the equation for change of state is asked. But still, PMM1 is important. What is PMM1? The question in thermodynamics will be like this. What is PMM1? Is it possible or impossible? Once this was given like, or what is PMM1? Explain. Then you can explain in your own words. In your own words, you can explain. What is PMM1? Now I am removing that slide. Now tell me, what is PMM1? Because the first law, second law, all these are experimental theories, experimental concepts, and there is no direct proof for this, no direct proof for establishing these laws, and therefore how not to make emission is explained. Not only how to make emission, it is explained how not to make emission, how emission cannot be established, how emission cannot be made. In that way, these are explained more beautifully. See, how to prepare or make a product is a theory. Of course, it can be said by anybody, but how not to make is very important also. That is explained by PMM1. What is PMM1? Not got you understood or not? PMM1. In one sentence, one of you tell. This can be explained in several ways. Out of several ways, one of you tell me the very fundamental first point of PMM1. Okay, what is the complete meaning of PMM1? What is the complete for which machine we abbreviate the name as PMM1? Abbreviation means short form. So PMM1 short form, then short form first.
Perpetual motion machine, sir.
Perpetual motion machine of first kind. Very good. What do you mean by perpetual motion machine? I told you what.
Cannot produce energy by taking some energy, sir.
Right. Perpetual, what do you mean by perpetual? I told you. Perpetual means continuously. A machine which continuously works without taking any energy. I told you, I have given you one good example. We, being human beings, cannot work hours together without taking any food. That is energy. Our emission, our bikes, scooties, they cannot move after the petrol is exhausted in the tank. Like that. If anybody can make it, it is a perpetual motion machine of first kind, which is not possible. You cannot drive a vehicle without petrol. Like that, you can understand perpetual motion machine of first kind. Okay, you said the complete form of PMM. Now, what is PMM1? Okay, you said a machine which will not work without any input of energy. Okay. Under which category does this PMM1 concept come under? It is a corollary of
corollary.
I will write here, for example. This is a corollary of first law of thermodynamics. Why more emphasis has been put on this? Because unless we understand these thoroughly, unless we are familiar with these terms, it is meaningless to enter into second law, some other concepts, corollary. This is corollary of first law of thermodynamics. That means I said it is a consequence of first law of thermodynamics. Upasiddhantamu antam. Upasiddhantamu. Like. This is a corollary of first law of thermodynamics. But see, in the examinations, you will be asked about PMM1 only. What is PMM1? Or explain the first law of thermodynamics and their corollary. Sometimes it may be given. Corollary means the consequence of. The consequence of first law of thermodynamics, a very beautiful concept of how not to make a machine, how you cannot make a machine is explained. That means you should not expect a machine to work continuously without any input of energy. That is what the consequence of first law of thermodynamics. You cannot, that is how the scientist in other way explain first law and how people cannot make a machine, how people for people it is impossible to make a machine and expecting the machine to work continuously without any input of energy. See, these English terminology you can put as in your own words. For example, sometimes I'm telling a machine cannot work without corresponding expenditure of energy, and sometimes no machine can produce energy without corresponding expenditure of energy. One of you, you tell me the meaning of this sentence in your own mother tongue. This sentence to convert into your own mother tongue in Telugu, for example. చెప్తున్నా అన్నట్టు నుంచి యు ఆర్ టెలింగ్ బట్ స్టిల్ ఐ ఎక్స్పెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్స్ ఆర్ రెస్పాన్సెస్ from the remaining people also, and that's why I'm asking you okay. See, the same person, you convert this sentence, this up to this point, into our own language. This sentence you convert into Telugu. For example, okay. It's okay. What is first law of thermodynamics for a cyclic process? For a cyclic process, first law of the thermodynamics is equal to network equal to net heat. network equal to net heat. And what do you mean by a cyclic process? Cyclic process. So this is cyclic integral dq equal to or cyclic integral q. That means sum of heat transfers in a cycle is equal to sum of work transfers in a cycle. See, the mathematical representation of a whole sentence, for example, the sentence is extended into three lines. When a system undergoes a thermodynamic cycle, then the net heat supplied to the system from the surroundings is equal to the net work done by the system on its surroundings. So, okay, whatever you write in length or in length like four or five lines, you can keep the same two long sentences in a brief mathematical equation like this. That is the power of mathematics. Cyclic integral dq is equal to cyclic integral d double, and where the cyclic integral represents sum of that parameter in a complete cycle, sum, or you can either write sigma over a cycle, dq equal to sigma d double over a cycle. That means on sigma we have to represent a cycle, meaning that over a cycle. So in that way, see, whenever a first law of thermodynamics is asked for a cycle, you can first write this brief equation, not all these sentences in two or three sentences. Whenever you write a mathematical equation, definitely you will roll your words automatically. The words will be rolled from anybody automatically. So that is the power of mathematics. That is why these concepts are, many concepts are in general represented with a very fundamental mathematical equations. So that's why you are expected to have, or you are expected to be interested in writing mathematical equations or recalling the mathematical formulae, which are very fundamental. We use fundamental formulae. Okay, what does this equation represent? I am asking you again, what does this equation represent? You speak, mute your mics, unmute your mics and speak. I will not go to chat box and verify. Don't chat, you speak. Okay.
Heat given body equal to work, sir.
Yes, repeat. Okay, you are correct, but repeat. Sum of heats in a cycle is equal to sum of works in a cycle. Now, that is how for a cyclic process, first law of thermodynamics is explained. And the first law is explained first by Joule's experiment. And that is not, of course, that is a preliminary experiment. And we, in a better way, we have these yesterday. For example, here, this is a change of state has occurred here. What is a cycle and what is a change of state? A cycle means if a system is initially at a certain state, suppose P1 and T1, then after many processes have taken place, or after the system has undergone many processes, if the system, the state of the system returns to its original state, then the system is said to have executed a cyclic process, or a system is undergone a cycle. In general, simple, in simple sentence, a cycle is executed. Like that, we can call, we can recall a cyclic process. Whereas here, I asked you, what is this? Now, initially, the potato, very cool potato, after purchasing from market, it is very cool. Now, and this is kept in a oven, and after giving electrical energy, the oven, the electrical energy will be converted into heat energy, and that heat is given to potato. And does the state of the potato change here? Here, does the state of initial state of potato remain same? Yes, sir. Not got potato ante bangalam pa telusadi. Okay, here I am asking you, the potato, here the oven is not shown here, it is kept in an electrical oven, and the oven is started by plugging it. And then it is after switching on the plug, the electrical oven, the potato in a few minutes time, it will be baked. Now I am asking you, does this come under a cycle or a change of state?
Change of state,
sir. Change of state, very good, because the potato is at a different state. Initially, it is hard, and it is too hard to eat. And now it is too hard to eat. But it can be taken. Whereas initially the potato is too cool and too hard to eat. Now finally the potato is of course hot. And after stabilization, even though the potato is cool, it cannot come to its initial state because it is baked. The state of the system has been changed now. So that is how here the complete heat Q is equal to Q that is given, 5 kilojoules, is converted into the internal energy of the potato. Internal energy of the potato. That is what I asked you. What is the first law of thermodynamics? For a change of state, the first law of thermodynamics is defined as Q is equal to E plus W, simply E plus W. Or you see every time I am showing you, but you are not. I don't know why you are not like. See here, Q is equal to U plus delta U plus W. Or E plus W. U stands for internal energy. E stands for the total energy of the system. Here, Q is equal to delta E. And you keep this W this side. Q is equal to delta E, change in the energy of the system plus W. In the potato case, I'm asking you to change this equation like this. Here, I will just write in a very legible manner. Now, this is the equation you have to remember. Now, is it visible clearly? Q equal to delta E plus W. Visible? Okay, I will share again. Now, is this visible to you? Q equal to delta E plus W. It is distinctly written. It is clearly written. Q equal to delta E plus W. This is first law of thermodynamics for a change of state. Here, what happened in the case of potato? An amount of heat, 5 kilojoules, is given to the potato, or the electrical energy is converted into, of course, heat, 5 kilojoules, and it is absorbed by the potato, and no work is done. W is zero. In the case of potato, W is zero. Now the entire 5 kilojoules heat is converted into the change in the energy of the potato. So that is how you always you remember this equation. This logical subject requires no need to remember anything actually. See, why no need to remember? I told you this equation can be even written by looking at this figure. This figure, for example, here suppose two amount of heat is given by a flame underneath, and suppose the piston has raised, double amount of work heat done, and some change in energy of the system, that is nitrogen. Nitrogen will be heated. So in that way, you can remember the heat given, Q is equal to D or delta E plus W. Delta E plus W. The work done by nitrogen. In that way, you can recall this figure and assume a flame underneath, a stove underneath, or this is kept on a stove, and the heat given by the flame or heat given to nitrogen is equal to the work that is because of the displacement of the piston and the change in the energy of nitrogen. Like that, you can remember dQ is equal to delta E plus W. Like that, you can remember. And I don't know why this equation. You can remember like Q is equal to delta E plus W. Here, now I am asking you, what are heat and W, heat and work? These are path functions or point functions? Heat and work are path functions. And can we write these as dQ and dW instead of Q? We can write, for example, delta E as D, and it can be differentiated. Why it can be differentiated? We will see now. But Q and W cannot be integrable. So a parameter which cannot be integrable is called a path function. A parameter which can be sorry, a parameter which can be integrable is called a point function. That means at every point, for example, delta E is integrated from 1 to 2, you can write E2 minus E. So E can be integrable. E can be integrable, but not Q and W. That is, we cannot write Q2 minus Q1. We cannot write W2 minus Q1. Therefore, these are not point functions. That means at any specific point, we cannot define Q and W. But delta E, energy, we can define. Okay, in that way, the for a change of state, we have to write the equation here. Now, one of you tell me, what is the net heat supplied to this? Is there any work interaction with the system? If this is taken as system, a dotted line, maybe I told you some food in a vessel, and if it is heated like this, now take the food as a system. Now I told you work and heat are path functions, and they will be observed at the system boundary, at the system boundary while they cross the system. So in that way, at the system boundary we have only heat transfers here. That means this much heat is given underneath, and because the vessel may be is because it is not insulated, some heat is wasted here, like what we do in our kitchens. And now there is heat interaction we have seen. Now is there any work interaction with the system? Tell me quickly, is there any work interaction with the system? Who is number 16? Alhar. Is there any work interaction? Number 3. See, heat interaction is denoted by Q. In Q underscript, in means heat that is entering, that is entering or in, Q in. And Q out, Q subscript out means heat that is leaving out because of maybe radiation or something else, like heat loss, heat given to the vessel. So the net heat is 12 kilojoule, and this entire 12 kilojoule is converted into the net change in the energy of the system. Here also the change of state has occurred. All these are that's why I ask you the very fundamental equation applicable to a process which undergoes a change of state. What is the equation? Again I am asking you, what is the equation that is applicable to a process which is for a process change of state, where a change of state has been occurring? Change of state means the system will attain another state, and it will not of course come back to the original state. Like that, if the state has changed, in what short way we write the first law of thermodynamics. Q equal to?
Q equal to delta E plus W, sir.
That's all. Delta E plus W. Here, here we have Qs. That means heat. And this delta E you have to find. Just I told you, these are the answers. What is delta E? We have to find. That is written here. But this is the answer. And here, heat interaction given. Forget about this 12. For example, forget about this 12 and delta E. I am asking you here, if this is the case, 15 kilojoules is entering, 3 kilojoules is leaving, and because there is no work interaction, if it is there, you could have been given, for example, with an arrow mark, W is equal to some 3 kilojoules like that. Because it is not there, there is no work either entering into the system or either done on the system or done by the system. And a W is equal to something, any okay, arrow mark inside, unte, work is done on the system. Arrow mark bite unte, work is done by the system. So, because no such nomenclature there. No such mention of W, that is work is there. We say that the W term is zero in your equation Q is equal to delta E plus W. So now the equation reduces to Q is equal to delta E only. Now what is Q here? Net heat. Net heat is R by sign convention. Heat that is in the input to the system is positive 15. We are calculating Q is equal to, in the equation Q is equal to delta E. We are calculating. Okay, again I will write on for example separate here. Q in, that is heat input is 15, heat out minus 3, heat rejected by system is negative, so 15 minus 3, so 12. So that means in the equation Q is equal to delta E plus W, Q is equal to 15 minus 3, 12, and 12 is equal to delta E plus W, where W is 0, or delta E is equal to 12. So in this way, this delta E, that is change in the energy of the system, is equal to 12 kilojoules, can be formed like that using the change of state equation, that is Q is equal to delta E plus W. We calculate delta E value. Here, these are all some problems. These are all problems given with answers. Because this is the beginning of beginning stage where you are just at the beginning of first class thermodynamics, I am giving you the answers. I am showing you the answers. At this stage, we don't attempt problems unless this law is understood thoroughly. So in the equation Q is equal to delta E plus delta E plus W, how are Q is equal to 15 kilojoules and Q out is equal to 3 kilojoules written? What is the sign convention for heat? The sign convention for heat is heat input to a system is positive and heat rejected or reheat that is coming out of a system is negative. And I said at the same time, the convention, that is sign convention for work is in the reverse order. That means if some W instead of QL, suppose I say W, if I put arrow mark like this, then it will be a negative value. Work done on a system is needed. And if this is instead of Q, it is W out. That means it is doing some work. So if the system is doing some work, it is positive. So in that way, the sign convention for work and sign convention for heat are in the reverse order. They are the universal sign convention which we can follow. Universally adopted sign convention. And the sign conventions and ENT, heat ki work ki a sign lo vaadali ante negative positive approval positive approval negative approval heat input to system is positive heat rejected or output from the system is negative mari work ki what about work there is okay for work what are the sign conventions I thought of entering into internal energy, showing internal energy a property before. That's why I have a little doubt on whether you understood the first law of thermodynamics for a change of state or not. That's why I reviewed all these to show that the energy. Internal energy or energy of the system is a property. Later, we will see. Here, what is the convention for work? Sign convention for work? సైన్ కన్వెన్షన్ అంటే ఏ సైన్, సైన్ అంటే నెగిటివ్ ఆ పాజిటివ్ వర్క్ కి ఏ ఏ సైన్ వాడాలి? నో రెస్పాన్స్. తెలీదా? తెలుసా? తెలీదా? See, many times we repeat it, and this repetition is because one should be thorough with these fundamental concepts, and with little intuition one can understand. Now, what is the sign convention for work? Anybody? Work sign convention is D. Work transfer. What is the sign convention for work transfer? Heat transfer, sign convention I told you. Heat that is entering into a system, or heat input to the system, heat input. Q stands for heat. Our convention is heat input to a system is positive, plus 15. Heat out from a system is negative, minus 3 kilojoules. So the net heat that is given to a system is 15 minus 3. So the net heat is, because there is no work transfer, the net heat must be converted into the net energy change. And therefore, this 12 kilojoules must have changed into the net energy change, must have been in the energy change. Like that, the energy conservation, law of conservation of energy, first law of thermodynamics, applied to a change of state. A change of state has occurred here. Initially, I told you that you assume that this is food. After heat is given, this will absorb the heat and it will be cooked. Like say anything, all of you. So like that, the state of the food has been changed. So for a change of state, Q is equal to delta E plus W is to be applied. And what is sign convention for work? Don't hesitate to answer and waste time. Work ki sign convention enti? Are you understanding the English language first? Why? Because all these are technical subjects. The subjects can be explained in a beautiful manner with English as a common language. Okay, what is the sign convention for work? Okay, if a certain device is producing work, what is that work? How is that work taken, positive or negative? If a certain machine is producing work, how will you take work, positive or negative?
Positive, sir.
Positive. The sign convention is marade. Ikkada sign convention means ila baitiki yaro chupistu W ani chupiste idi 3 kilojoules, W is equal to 3 kilojoules ani chupiste dani ardham entante work is done by system, by baiti chupiste work is done by system. Our system is doing work. Our system is giving some work output. Like that. Ala output work kundu danni positive work antu. Ikkada Q badu W anukondi. Ila unte W in anunte work is requiring some work ani. Alanti aithe negative work antu. Adhe sign convention ante. Sign convention ante adhe. So the work input is, if there is input of work, then it is taken to be negative. If there is some output of work, ikkada output ante meeku ardham kaadu, produce ante ardham avutundi. If any machine produce some work ante takku ani cheptunnaru, positive sound. Ikkada produce work means output. Output means the machine is giving out, the machine is producing output. The terminology you have to habituate. These terminology, output, input. Input ante manam tentam. For example, our input when we eat, it is called input. Input. Breakfast. If you take breakfast, it is input of energy. Like that. If we do some work, it is output of energy. Output of energy. Output of our body. Like that. Out and producing some like that. The terminology has to be habituated and in the little time you will be no doubt habituated to this terminology. Later in the coming class, why I put more effort on this equation, that is, for a change of state, the equation for first law is this, as you said, Q is equal to delta E plus W. This is to explain that energy, a property of system. So we will explain this after, in the next class. This is, see here, to explain energy, a property of system, the very first equation we use is the change of the first law of thermodynamics for a change of state, or when a system undergoes a change of state, the system is changing its state. And here, for example, how many cycles are shown here? This is one cycle, that is 1 to 2 over L, and returning back, returning to initial state 1 over N, and again going from 1 to 2 along L and coming back to 1 along N. So here the return process has been shown in two ways. One way is along path M, along process M, another way is along path M. So this way two cycles are shown here. Two cycles are shown. And we will play first of thermodynamics for a cycle as well as for a change of state for every cycle, for every process in a cycle. In the coming class, we will see that. So you understand these equations for change of state as well as for a cycle. You understand. Okay, thank you.